She is the owner of Piedmont Restaurant in North Carolina and the author of The Farmhouse Chef. And today, she is back in our kitchen showing us how to make her famous tomato pie. Yes. Welcome back, Jamie Dement, to our home. We love it when you're here.
I love being here.
We eat so well when you come
here. That's my golden life.
It's our goal to eat your food. Yeah, we're winning too, honey. So this tomato pie really is a Southern classic.
It is absolutely a Southern classic. This version is a little different. It's kind of a modern twist on it. Traditionally, tomato pie in the South will have mayonnaise in it. And to me, that's shocking and appalling.
Yeah.
Like, who wants to eat warm mayonnaise?
Yeah. Especially in the summertime when it's sitting out, it's a little tricky.
You want something light and lovely. And so this is a fun, modern, healthy spin on it. It's a basic pie crust with heirloom tomatoes and fresh mozzarella and fresh herbs.
I always say it's like a twist on a pizza.
It is.
I love it.
It's like a fancy French twist.
It is.
Yes.
So it starts with a blind baked pie crust.
Yes, it does.
So, you know, blind baked.
It's a basic butter pastry.
Okay.
Super simple. Butter and flour.
Are you a pie weight kind of girl or a dried beans kind of girl?
I am a pie weight kind of girl because dried peas or beans can have hidden moisture. Mm. Sometimes they'll explode in the oven and make a mess.
Who
wants a mess? So we use, pie weight.
Yeah, it's
every
important.
Time.
And it's also very important to poke your pie crust before you get it going.
What you're doing here is making sure that when you're putting a wet ingredient in your pie, that you're not going to have a soggy crust.
Right.
So we're taking,
nobody likes a soggy crust.
Yeah, nobody wants a soggy crust. So we're just taking a fork, you know, pretty forcefully dabbing some holes in there.
So this is really the key to having a crunchy crust at the bottom.
Yeah, you want it to be nice and crunchy under there so that you don't have a soggy mess.
Right.
And then we're going to take just a basic piece of parchment paper.
Lay it down. Another thing about this is so easy. This is something great that you could put together and take to someone's house for a party.
Yeah, and it stands up. So once it's cooked, it can, it can sit around for a while. It's great at room temp. It kind of needs to be room temp so it's not floppy when you eat it.
Blind baked.
What
does that mean?
You put on a blindfold and you just put it.
Yeah, you hold your hands over your eyes when you're cooking like this.
And you hope for the best.
Yes, you just say, dear Jesus, help. Yeah. No, you just, it means that you're putting it in here and baking it to sear in the crustiness. And then
you're pre-baking a little bit, but not all the way through because you're going to bake it again.
That's what makes it crunchy.
Yeah, that's what makes it crunchy. You've stabbed it with your fork, you've put your pie weights in, then you're going to pop it in the oven and cook it for 10 minutes. And it's just going to barely be crusty. You can see this guy right here that has already, he's already done. Mm-hmm. He's got his little pie, his little pokes in the bottom.
He's ready to go, but he's not fully cooked.
So next is
We add our tomatoes. Now, what kind of tomatoes? Can you use any kind of tomatoes or a specific bunch of tomatoes?
Never, ever. That is the most important question when it comes to using tomatoes. There is no tomato that's not an heirloom tomato, as far as I'm concerned.
Okay, and so it has to be heirloom.
It has to be heirloom. When you're talking about vegetables, it means the same thing as when you're talking about jewelry. When you've got that, that beautiful diamond of your grandmother's that she passed down that you valued, well, this tomato, somebody's great Aunt Bibi saved that seed because it was beautiful and delicious and is going to look good in my tart.
And it's been passed down from generation to generation. So when a man gets on his knee and gives you a tomato, you say yes.
You say yes, thank you. It's true.
You say I do.
Yes.
You say this from Aunt Bibi.
Yes, right, exactly. Aunt Bibi passed this down.
Now, I know, Mark, your wife loves to garden.
She does. She loves cooking. You know, we call it adulting now.
Yes.
Right.
And we on our honeymoon, we went to Thailand and we got to see all these like homegrown basil and herbs and my wife's just like, see, babe, we need to be doing this at home.
You know what we're gonna do?
That's next for us.
Today we're gonna give you a seed from this heirloom.
When you go home,
you're gonna say this is your anniversary.
There you go.
Okay.
And she'll have a few things to say.
Yeah, she'll be so happy.
Please take this tomato.
Yes.
Okay. So we put the tomatoes in the pie crust.
This is a super simple dish to prepare. It's almost embarrassing sometimes how simple it is. So you make a pinwheel. You just start with your tomato.
It looks so pretty when you're done.
And
the thing about the heirloom tomatoes, because they come in so many different colors, even the purple ones, it makes it that much more beautiful as well.
Oh, absolutely. And when you serve it, people are like, oh, my gosh, look at all that. And it looks like you've done something, just absolutely magical, when really all you've done is, had a small arts and crafts project.
But also the freshness of all of the ingredients is also so...
it's just so great to have ingredients that are so fresh and vibrant.
Yes.
And it doesn't matter what kind of mozzarella you use?
It's fresh mozzarella. Okay. So, you know, buy the best mozzarella you can. I mean, where we are, we're lucky. We have friends, Chapel Hill Creamery, who own a creamery near us. And so, we call them up and get really good cheese. But, you know, in general, find the best you can. Buy organic when you can.
Do you have cows on the farm?
We have cows for beef, but not dairy cows. Oh. We have had dairy cows in the past.
So you could have made your own cheese.
I did. I used to make my own cheese. Our dairy cow was named Eudora Welty, and she was a very sweet girl.
That's a very big name for her.
She was a big girl.
Oh, I
see. She was a big girl and real sweet. So you just sprinkle around.
And should we put some more
cheese? Yes, we should put some more
because
cheese.
Because I always feel like there can never be enough.
Yes, there can never be enough.
There you go.
Save a cute one for the middle.
Okay.
Put that
there you
one
go. That's a good one.
Yeah, okay.
The other one's like
there you go.
This.
Are you
yes.
double layering the tomato or just one layer?
I just do one layer when they're this big. Yeah, so one layer and then one in the middle, and then you just finish it. You take your fresh herbs and scatter them.
And if you don't have fresh herbs?
If you don't have fresh herbs, you can use dried. They work fine.
Okay.
With the dried herbs, cut the recipe in half.
Oh, right, because they are more pungent.
They're a lot more pungent. So this is fresh oregano and basil.
Okay.
And just sprinkle it all around.
A little bit of salt and pepper.
A little salt and pepper.
Look how
pretty that is.
Really,
I mean, you barely
beautiful.
Even have to cook it. It's gorgeous.
I mean, I feel like someone could open a shop, like a tomato pie shop.
They should.
You know what I mean? Instead
of
pizza.
And you can do it with, you know, if you wanted to do goat cheese or feta, anything like that works. You can kind of make it your own. Do whatever you want.
Should I
drizzle,
do it?
Yeah, drizzle olive oil.
Across.
Yeah.
Okay, beautiful like
okay.
that. And we pop it back in for how long?
It's ready to go into the oven for 30 minutes at 350 degrees.
And you can grab that other one.
So that one is in there. And through the magic of television, we have one that is already ready.
Oh. That is so beautiful.
Could you also prepare that at your house and then take it to somebody's
Absolutely,
house?
Absolutely, yes.
And as a hostess gift or something?
Yes, like it's a perfect, like, you know, make ahead and carry
something.
And then leave behind the tray.
Yeah, as a gift.
Like that.
Yeah, that makes a great gift.
Aren't
you smart today?
Look at
it. Yes.
Today.
Today. I like that. Thank you for noticing. Changes from day to day.
Yeah.
So then a little bit of balsamic.
Yeah, just finish it with a drizzle.
Like that.
You can do it, on the pie or on the plate, either way. And that'll give it a little acidity that kind of breaks down the salt and the fat that's already in the pie.
All right,
and here you are.
Get in here.
They're so
beautiful, Jamie.
I can use my poke fork.
You can use your poke fork.
Question. Not only are you cooking for us today,
yes.
but I also heard you cooked at your own wedding on your own farm.
I did.
Which sounds crazy because when we got married, I was stressed picking food.
But yeah,
I know.
Maybe you're not a control freak, but I was able. We're really lucky. We live on a farm, and it's really beautiful. And when we were trying to decide what to do for a wedding, we kept looking at all these venues, and it was obvious that where we lived was prettier.
Yeah,
and so we had the wedding at our farm, and I did a lot of the food prep ahead of time. You know,
cool.
I made salads. I made we had a slider station, and so I made lamb sliders and beef sliders. I made tomato pies.
Hey.
I made tons of different salads and biscuits and all, you know, just kind of fun things. I did it all the week before. And so, you know, the day of the wedding, I was able to get up and have a fabulous day because we have a good friend who's a caterer, and Colleen did a phenomenal job of you know, basically curating everything and putting everything together.
And you know what? For someone who's a chef, that's really important because the last thing you want to do on the day of your wedding, say, oh my gosh, my food was not what I wanted it to be.
Yeah, and so
everything was
doing
perfect.
It that way was perfect. It was the perfect marriage.
And this is perfect.
Yeah.
This
Thank
tomato
you.
Pie is the perfect marriage
so good.
Between cheese
so
and tomatoes.
Good.
Thank you
oh,
so much.
I love
much.
You, Jamie. Please do not stay away for too long.
I won't.